Hello students, today we will learn chapter 1, food. Where does it come from? So why do we need food? We know that all living things, be it plants and animals, need food and water to live on. We need food because food gives us energy. So food we eat gives our body essential nutrients to help us grow and heal when we are injured or when we are ill. Thus food keeps us healthy and provides us essential nutrients to fight diseases. So think about rice cooked at home. We take raw rice and boil it in water. So just two materials or ingredients are needed to prepare a dish of boiled rice. So what we use is nothing but ingredients. So the components or materials required to prepare a food item are called ingredients. So in the picture you can observe different food items. To prepare a food, we need different kinds of ingredients. Like to cook vegetable curry, we need different kinds of vegetables, salt, spices, oil, etc. Now let us see the food items and their ingredients. So to prepare roti or chapati, we need atta and water. So atta and water are the ingredients here. And to prepare the food item dal, we need the following ingredients: pulses, water, salt, oil or ghee and spices. So these are some of the food item and ingredients. Now let us see food materials and sources. So plants and animals are the two sources of our food materials. Milk, egg, meat, chicken, fish, prawn, etc. are the food products that we get from animals. Now let us see the products that we get from plants. Grain, cereals, vegetable and fruits comes from plants and plants products. So we eat leafy vegetable, fruits and some parts of plants like stem and roots. So in the picture you can observe the plant sources and animal sources. Now let us learn plant parts and animal products as food. So plants are one source of our food. We eat many leafy vegetables, we eat fruits of some plants, sometimes roots, sometimes stems and even flowers. So some plants have two or more edible parts. Edible means eatable. So seeds of mustard plants gives us oil and the leaves are used as a vegetable. Students, do not try to taste unknown plants around you to see if they are edible, because some plants could be poisonous. So it is dangerous to taste the unknown plants. So do you know where honey comes from or how it is produced? So honeybees collect nectar from flowers, convert it into honey and store it in their hive. So flowers and their nectar may be available only for a part of year. So bees store their nectar for their use throughout the year. Now let us learn about sprouted seeds. So the germinating seeds are the initial stages when a white structure has grown out of the seed. They are called sprouted seeds. Let us learn how to prepare them. So take some dry seeds of moong or chana. Put a small quantity of seeds in a container filled with water and leave this aside for a day. Next day, you drain the water completely and leave the seeds in the vessel. So wrap them with a piece of wet cloth and set aside. So next day, you will observe that white structure has grown out of it. So you can observe in the picture. So you will get the white structure like that. So these are sprouted seeds. So you can eat them as it is or boil them in it. So they are very healthy. So animal products like meat, egg, honey, milk, curd, cheese, butter and ghee are eaten by human beings. So these are the products that are available from animals. Now let us see what do animals eat. So a dog, cat, buffalo or a goat, you will then If you have as a pet, you will surely be aware of the food the animals eat. So different animals have different feeding habits. Based on their feeding habits, animals can be divided into three groups: herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous. So in the picture you can observe squirrel eating nuts. Now let us learn about herbivorous animals. So animals which eat only plants and plant products are called herbivorous. Example of this type of animals are elephant, rabbit, horse, cow, etc. herbivorous animals. Now next, let us learn about carnivorous animals. So animals which eat other animals are called carnivorous. Example, lizard, lion, tiger, crocodile, etc. carnivorous. Next type of animals are omnivorous. So these animals eat both plants and animals. For example, dog, cat, crow, etc. are omnivorous animals. So we know that there are many amongst us who do not get sufficient food. So we need to find ways by which more food can be produced in the country. That will not be enough. We will need to find ways to ensure that this food is made easily available to each one of us. So we should never waste the food. Okay students, we have completed with chapter 1, food. Where does it come from? So go through the video 2 to 3 times to get the clear understanding of the concepts. Thank you.